dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team pick.
Death Prophet.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Dark Seer.
Dire team pick.
Undying waits.
Radiant team pick.
All right, everybody, welcome back into the Shanghai Major qualifiers for the American region. It is Team Freedom Dota 2 versus Shazam. We're here in our second game and the last game that we'll be doing before we take a break and head over to the couch over on Muduk TV. With that said, my name is Watt. Joining me today, of course, is Cart Dota or Krat Dote and Purge Gamers. We're into the draft, man. How are you feeling right now?
I'm just happy that we're seeing all dead heroes so far, and it continues.
It's friends.
It is a game of zombies, ghosts, and skulls.
What you said? Let's just say. Oh man, I'm sorry. I'm having a really weird day. I'm not gonna lie. It's been strange, and that lighted my mood up a little bit. So, thanks for that, dude. I appreciate it.
I was being serious.
5 seconds.
Oh, I know. So, Darkseer Undying, huh? Death Prophet, Witch Doctor, they're gonna get picked first. You know, somebody messaged me just a little while ago saying they hated the way Shazam played, which with the strong push strat. And I thought, that's pretty poignant, you know? Because there, how much can you really do up against a Chen, Lone Druid, Death Prophet? It's like, okay, there's a bear hitting our tower, and now it's a Death Prophet with Exorcism hitting our tower, and now it's Chen with like 4,000 creeps and an early Agony separating our tower. What do we do? You have to just kind of wonder at that point.
That's the scary part. Like, you grab DP Witch Doctor and you're like, okay, two regular heroes, and then all of a sudden it's a push strat in the second phase. And if you didn't have the heroes to deal with it, then you're in a bad spot. So Freedom starts off with the Darkseer themselves, and Shazam continues with their same picks. So Darkseer is a good solution against it. It's not the best creeps or take control of them if you're playing Chen. But there was actually an enchant banned in the first round. So, as long as Freedom bans Chen,
Radiant team ban.
So fear the push. badly.
All right, Freedom, you know what to do now. You don't have the band right now, but you need to use it, and you need to use it effectively. I believe in you. Beastmaster is also banned because they're clearly scared of this push. They've banned out the Lone Druid first phase. They've banned out the Beastmaster second phase, which is also very good at pushing. You get a Necromaster or Necro book on Necromastery. That'd be pretty funny if you get the skill from Shadow Fiend. But nonetheless, you get a Necro book and all of a sudden your towers are gone. You know, like at minute 20 or maybe even earlier. I'm not sure when they took that last tier 2 tower, but they died pretty quickly. So the Titan will get banned out for Shazam, surprisingly enough. I'm not sure why. I would ban out an Ember Spirit if I was Shazam because they play that hero every game. That's what I would do. 5 seconds remaining.
With the bans being gone, teamfight heroes, nukers, for the same kind of thing here.
Team pick.
Like, and Freedom either knows the Darkseer counter, or they're paying attention to his DC game with the Medusa.
Yeah, I like that Medusa ban. They'll pick up another hero here. Maybe they grab the Chen. I highly doubt that, but there's always a possibility that'll happen. I don't think they should... Shazam have no real reason not to pick the same lineup, with the exception of the Lone Druid. I don't see why you don't pick Chen here. Is there any reason why you don't go Chen in this game? Maybe the pick that comes out now will show why they don't go Chen.
Maybe it's not that it's not that good against Darkseer. Really. Yeah, you can take over the Iron Shield creep or whatever, but if it kills your creep wave, that is a large portion of your damage. It's also the tankiness. Like Chen provides good tower damage, but you need the creeps to hit tower and you need your creeps to hit tower. Both really take towers really. So I feel like Darkseer is already pretty punishing of a strat. Plus it synergizes with the other hero that Freedom likes drafting, which is Ember Spirit, because you can Iron Shell on the Ember and then you're doing like over 100 magic damage a second. So instead they go for a Gyrocopter. Obviously Sunbee is their mid player, so but Gyrocopter is already going to be a carry solution against the push, better than Viper.
Yes.
Call down, Flat Cannon, Rocket Barrage, lots of solutions to kill large amounts of units.
Yeah, even with an early item scepter, I mean, the ancient granite golem and a couple of those other groups will be difficult to take down. But nonetheless, I mean, I agree with completely. Gyrocopter is very strong as a counter push, as a deep push. There's a lot of abilities you can use, and I doubt they'll go Chen now. They could still do it if they want to. If MSS is that confident in his Chen play, if they're that comfortable with that hero, they certainly could. But I don't want to fixate too much on that hero, as they're going to be another hero picked up here within a minute and 30 seconds of reserve time. So SVG, I think, played the Witch Doctor last game. He did. Death Prophet was played by Ritsu. So we're still looking for Mason, Brax, and MSS hero for the next pick. And with a Darkseer picked up, we already saw what a Nyx Assassin could do. I don't think that's going to be the case. I think that's exclusively DC support kind of thing. Maybe I'm wrong about that.
They could. I just don't know the best solution. It's good against the Darkseer, but... carry, or they could... I doubt they'll put Death Prophet in the safe lane, because I think Ritsu showed some pretty good value with Death Prophet in the mid lane, but I think there are more Darkseer options. They could even do something like Doom if they really want to, but I don't know if Doom is super viable yet.
We'll go for Tusk. Man, if only the Ancient Stack slash pole was not removed. Because I really liked that. I thought that was pretty neat.
It was so bullshit. Are you kidding me?
I mean, it was really bullshit, but it was fun to watch. I'll put that.
It wasn't even that good. It mostly penalized the enemy mid more than it helped the Tusk, because you'd have to pull twice to kill one Ancient.
Yes, I know that. I mean, well, that's the thing. It's not great for the Tusk, which is why I thought it was okay. I mean, he'll get levels from it. He'll do okay. He'll get some last hits and some farm. But it's really for your mid to get not even guaranteed experience, because the other mid laner could always just walk up and try to deny you. But it just is the other mid can't get that farm that you're pulling in. Yeah, I don't think it's that bad. I mean, it's kind of bad. I mean, denying
kind of like groups. I really like Tusk against Gyro, though, in this case, because if he does do cooldowns, you can always pull anybody that's weak into it, including Chen creep. They happen to choose Chen. I don't think they will against Gyro Darkseer. I think it's already a little bit tough for Chen. They should focus more on team fighting and ganking.
And even with the Dazzle, too, the Shadow Wave could take down some Chen creeps rather easily.
Yeah, definitely.
So
way to slow things down, or keep your creeps alive longer just by healing.
They're really low on disables from Team Freedom's side. And I think this Undying could be an offlaner. They get a core or a support with the stun, which I'm perfectly fine with. But like if you look at Shazam, it's like, okay, we have Cast, we have Walrus Punch, we have Snowball, we have Lasso, we have Flame Break, we have a lot of disables. Team Freedom's like, well, we got Vacuum, but that doesn't cancel anything. I mean, we have It's not great. Yeah, we have poison touch level 4. We have homing missile. Woo.
I think Shazam has really drafted their two-game set really well, because the first game they put us off with a strategy, and then in the game two they say, oh, look, we're going to do the strat, guys, and then Freedom starts picking around it, and they're like, JK, we're going ganking. Freedom's like, I thought we were going to counter-push and keep our hero. And Dazzle's good at that, obviously, but if you grab Dazzle or if you grab somebody else in Dazzle, then Freedom gets screwed with their draft.
Yeah. That's a very good point. And I imagine this Batrider is going to be a menace the entire game. There's no natural linkage sphere builders on this team, which I think was the big issue for DC versus Elite Wolves in that first game, is that they had two linkage sphere builders in the Quap as well as the Morphling. And against a Batrider, it's not like you need that 100%, but it's really strong. Otherwise, you're going to get picked up, you're going to get destroyed with the last one on top of you. Remaining. It's a bit scary.
Well, with their last pick, they've already got two supports, neither of which are aggressive, so they need a mid hero that can gank. I'm not 100% sure what it's going to be, but it also needs damage, because it needs to be able to help them kill the Death Prophet, because right now they have awful damage. I really do. It's basically, what, Shadow Wave and Gyrocopter,
yeah,
and a little bit of damage over time from Darkseer. Like, that's what they needed. They needed some single target damage. I don't know if it's going to be the perfect solution. I don't know if they're even going to kill Death Prophet. I'm very hesitant about Dazzle plus Undying, because once they get behind, they have no gank possibility. A lot of teams really do need. I think the Dazzle was the wrong pick, and there was the wrong pick, but once. I don't think any of their last picks might have covered their bases, except for maybe like an OD or something. Yeah, OD would have been okay. OD would have been.
I mean, OD at least has a fairly, you know, reliable disable and Astral Imprisonment. I mean, Shackle Shot's okay.
OD, I think if they had a good OD player, they could kill Death Prophet, could banish somebody and run away. Like if Tusk snowballs on somebody, you can banish yourself.
Yep.
Banish whoever gets Batrider lassoed. I think OD was the.
Yeah.
And so I don't look stupid.
No, I would have said something if it was banned. I'd be like, Purge, I don't know about that, but that's not the case. They didn't pick it, they don't have it. It's just kind of surprising for how good OD is. Necro picked up for Shazam as their safe laner.
Those assholes, you know what they're going to do? They're going to be like, Batrider lasso, ulti somebody, game ends. Basically what's going to
happen. That's it. Would they ulti the person that's lassoed, or they ulti somebody else?
Well, you're going to lasso somebody in a position, they ulti them, and then they're playing 4v5 for 90 seconds.
That's true.
Every time that they use the Necrophos ulti, they take another.
Because then you just exorcism after that. You just run up at the high ground.
And they're not going to want to fight you.
God, that's awful. That's just. I mean, you can even just go in with like Tusk, Doctor, Necrophos. You pop up a couple of death pulses, you get the ice shards off, and then you catch them. You don't even need lasso. I mean, you could use it. I mean, it's nice to have theoretically, and it's safer than, you know, just running at the enemy team. But you could run at the enemy team. You do have to deal with Shadow Wave, you do have to deal with Grave, Weave, Undying, with Gyrocopter. There is that kind of thing if you run at them. I don't know, man. I'm completely okay with this lineup for Shazam. I haven't seen a Necrophos in forever. If my brother was watching, he'd be super down for this game right now. Because he is a huge Necrophos fan.
Necro is occasionally a really, really good. I think this is going to be one game where it's quite good. They do have to worry about Dazzle, of course, but you know, they can always just silence Dazzle and blow him up. Pretty straightforward. Up anybody, and a lot of the heroes on the Dire team are a little weak to magic damage, and the Radiant team does have pretty good nuke set up those. So I think Necro's.
Yeah, Mace is going to play in the safe lane, which is not something you see every day. What's the itemization? Do you get an early Atos, or does he go for the mech? Because I don't think they have a real mech carrier. I mean, I guess Tusk could get it, but I'm not sure that's going to be the case for MSS.
Atos versus a Darkseer, I think, is a little bit of a bad idea due to Surge.
That. Yeah,
but. And normally, I would say yes. He could do something like Force Mech. He could. I don't really like an Ags, but I just feel so confident about the Radiant team's draft that I feel like whatever item Necro wants to go, that's fairly viable.
He could go full pub build, build a Dagon, and still win, is what you're telling me.
I don't know about a Dagon build, but he could go like Octarine Rush. He could go Ags Rush or something, maybe. Just about anything like that. I think he'll be his team's mech carry, though. I think he's going to go mech into, like, either Ags or,
I will agree with you on that point. The mech is, I mean, they have a mech carrier in him, or the Tusk, not really the Tusk as much anymore as it used to be, but especially with MSS playing in the four position, they're not going to get that early mech from him, so the best person to do so is going to be Mason, who, by the way, is now solo bottom for at least a little bit of time as SVG was mid, maybe looking to give some help to Ritsuko back up, and hey, I think he's going to head to the bottom lane through this little staircase. He's actually going to see Jubei here. They're going to cross paths momentarily. Yeah, he saw him. He definitely saw him.
Much more regen on Jubei, so he can't really trade too hard. So you just watch where his opponent is.
What was that attack? Did you see that?
That was like 400 unit.
He's like, I'm gonna swipe you and the wind will do the damage. Okay.
So Mason is against the Darkseer, which is a pretty good one because he's gonna counteract any harass that he takes. His third skill, Sadist, and also...
Mm-hmm.
Just fine matched up against the Darkseer. He can sit here 1v1. He doesn't have to worry about the Darkseer too much.
Maybe early when he doesn't have Sadist. Oh god, SVG, buddy. This is not the play. He actually has to stand behind the tower and boot a restoration up. That's frightening. And it actually heals so much because he has no HP.
That's actually a really good value here. He used a little bit too much voodoo.
Yeah, oh, the Tango coin. He got the ward too. Tango that bad boy. Got it.
Waste a little bit of mana, but like you said, yeah, he's getting a huge percentage of heal out of any heal that he gets when his HP is. It's like tread switching. He's essentially tread.
That's pretty funny when you think about it. 8 last hits coming out for the Windranger in the mid lane, so... the biggest problem with the Windranger is that even if you focus fire and you have an Ags, I think you need another item to do a little bit more damage. I mean, but generally, it should be enough. You get an early focus fire Aghanim Scepter and you'll be fine, but... I feel like you do really need 2 damage items to be super successful with that hero. Sometimes we'll see even a Maelstrom built first before you get that Aghanim Scepter, and that's something that's been sort of popular recently and was way popular a long time ago before Ags was really good.
It's definitely one thing that holds them back. If you don't get like Daedalus Ags, then you're just having Ags or something, then you're like, okay, well, I have to get a BKB now, and then BKB with an Ags, which is red damage. It leaves this really period of time that's kind of dangerous for you.
Yeah, so we'll see what he decides to go for. He's already doing a good job. The Death Prophet's also got decent CS. 10 last hits for Ritsu and 13 coming up for Sunbee. I think Sunbee gets a lot of flack, but the last couple of games I've seen him in, he's played okay. He's played well, but he's taking a lot of damage now, and he has 1 Fairy Fire. There's going to be the Spirit Siphon almost bringing him down. Bottle will come in, and we'll provide him the HP and backup that he needs.
Now Brax is he's 3 here. He's a dual lane going with MSS. Kind of a cool dual lane because they can snowball into whoever they're chasing after. So if somebody does get too many attacks on them, they can't go for the... It's a gyrocopter. Not exactly somebody right on top of it.
Right, that's true. Unless he just kind of gets caught out, takes a little bit of creep damage, maybe getting a couple of ice shard ticks going to him and hurting him. So I don't think... They might dive the Dazzle, they could even dive the Gyrocopter if it gets caught out in bad position, but right now he's fine. Bottom lane, that's where the action's gonna happen. As you can see, the Tombstone has dropped, Jubei is running after, he's got no mana, he does have a Mango. That will not provide him the kill though, so he won't
use it. He got blocked in by
blocked zombie. In, but they don't know. The zombie finally moves out of the way. That was really cool, the zombie's like, oh, excuse me, sir, let me let you out of here.
Can't he just, like, do a somersault over the zombie and let the zombie in? Zombie is like as big as his kneecap. Like,
you can kick the zombie out of the way.
Can't kill one of my babies. I would feel bad.
You should be able to deny your zombies. I think that's a good point.
They actually rotated the gyro down here. And they're going to put Darkseer top, I guess. Cast? But now, like.
Death Pulse, is he dead? One more right click? Yeah, he's dead. Oh, it's going to be close. There it is. Last right click. And that's first blood for Mason. That rotation did not work as well as they wanted. Another Death Pulse will fly. Soul Rip will go again. They don't have the damage to actually bring him down. It's going to be close, but he'll Fairy Fire himself up to health. Plus, he had 4 stick charges on top of that. Nonetheless, that is first blood on a Gyrocopter who literally just rotated bottom. So he got no TP scroll.
There's no way that Mason didn't say sick rotation, bro, or something. Like, I would be like, what the hell are you doing, man?
How does he not all chat there?
Necro's actually a decent V1 hero. You don't just rotate to his lane and not see him as... He's very dangerous. Even as against Gyro, he's got a heal, he's got a close range melee nuke. Like, if you're swinging that much health and doing that much damage, same little button press, like, Gyro's gonna lose.
And he's gonna go back bottom, regardless. I mean, to be fair, he only has 5 last hits. That dual lane top was very dangerous. MSS and Brax are having a pretty good time. Brax has 19 last hits, and again, this is one of those instances where Shazam are actually dominating this early game. They have more CS in the mid lane. They have more CS in the bottom lane by far. and they have more CS in the top lane. So they're pretty much winning every lane right now. There's not a lane that is going poorly for them. Maybe the jungle, but I don't think that's actually the case. I mean, there's nobody in there. The Darkseer is... Where is the Darkseer? Is he top still? He is. So Mike's not doing that great.
And the Gyro didn't have boots yet due to him getting a fast magic wand against the Batrider. So because of that reason, he got killed by the Necrolich.
Yeah, really tough. And he's going to pick up the Robe of the Magi for the Mason. Cast will fly through. Rocket Barrage is going to come up. Here's MSS. He's got level 1 Ice Shard and Snowball. SVG's getting kind of low. There's the Tombstone. Snowball will keep him up in the lock for now. Now they're going to bring him in. Medeski Fan gets Sorb. Nicely done. They take down the Tombstone, and that's a lot of damage going by the wayside. Rocket Barrage, they do get the kill on one. Can they get MSS? No, he falls. The damage of Mason is too strong. The Death Pulse hit him at the right time. Got enough mana for another Death Pulse. He's going to use it here in a moment. Decay will fly. He's very tanky. Very tough to bring down Jubei right now. Looking for MSS. Can't quite get him. There's a Mangle. He'll pop it off. Gets the Grave up and ready to go, but he can't get out in time. There's the Shadow Wave. They pop up another Death Pulse, and Mason gets a killing spree. Not a double, though. Another Ice Shard blocks only for a moment there. Almost caught him in. The Death Pulse is up. Can he get close enough? It will hit, it looks like. And that's going to be a triple kill. Well, no, a double kill. Dominating spree is what I meant. And of course, Medeski Fan comes back in. He'll get caught. Mason has another Death Pulse. God, the Sadist is just owning.
Yeah, if you get kills on Necro, it's a more bonus regen. So he gets like, I don't know, 60 health or something.
MSS is dead. Yeah, no, it's nice. That's for damn sure. He's gonna go mech. He's gonna pick up the headdress, and he already has the Robe of the Magi. He'll get a buckler now, too. He has 900 gold. There's no way he just doesn't buy a buckler right now. He bought a Glove of Haste. Is he getting Midas? Or is that just gonna be part of his Trez? Like, that's
yeah,
not...
Treads into mech is going to be his build, just like a...
Okay. Nice.
Treads is really good on Necro because you go to Int Treads, and when you cast it, you waste when you cast Deathful, and it heals you for a higher percentage of your HP, so going Treads is just such good value on Necro.
Yep.
It's like really hard to pass up.
Tread swapping is just that's the bee's knees on this hero.
How are they going to kill this guy? If they've called on, maybe, but...
He's not even level 6 yet, nor does he have phase. Turtle will bring up the Treads. There's the headdress, as you talked about. SVG is going to go ahead and spot them out. The Observer Ward was placed down by Jubei. I think they probably noticed that they even pinged out, though. SVG only has Boots of Speed, surprisingly enough, in this bottom lane. He's actually not done that well for himself. He died once. He was involved in 2 kills, though. Well, we've kept our eye here for a little longer than I would have liked. What's Brax doing? 1,700 gold, another early blink coming out again. These Batriders, man, Jesus.
Batriders apparently still a good hero. He's very scary in the laning stage. He's scary if he's by himself, and then you put another hero with him, and you're like, okay, this is really dangerous. He's getting neutral creeps, he's getting jungle creeps, he's getting lane creeps, he's getting so much advantage out of this hero.
Medeski Fan will stay alive, good grave coming through.
Going for the ult.
Mason.
Oh, he might get this kill. Oh, I think he got Mike. Nice, that was a really nice kill by Brax here.
That vacuum.
That was really sick.
Swing and a miss. I didn't see most of it.
He basically chased up to Mike and he waited for the surge and then he lassoed him and he started stacking up the napalm and then ran the way that Mike was going to run right when his lasso ended and then followed up with a couple of techs. It was really nicely played by Brax. I didn't see that coming.
That's pretty nifty. Not only does that stop Mike from getting any farm, it also gives him the blink, which he pretty much already had. I mean, this is going great for Shazam. There's no reason this game shouldn't end in a 2-0 for this series. But it's too early to say. Sunbeast's still doing okay, mate. He's got just about the same amount of net worth that the Death Prophet does. Down bottom, this Observer Ward is the only thing keeping Mischief alive. They do not see that this is here. SVG, any sentries coming through? No. Still only has Boots of Speed and a TP Scroll. No stick even. Mason's getting plenty of farm. He is going to have his mech at like 10 minutes in, maybe even later or earlier than that.
In a really good spot, you're totally right. And Reds with a full magic wand, you need all these little survivability items in the early game because if you do have them, it allows you to outplay your opponent's heals in the right. He'll be maxing out Sadist now, so every last hit he gets gives him even more mana and HP.
Yep, there's that level 2 of it. Level 1 is like, it's not even that good, but you can see after every engagement, he would just get more and more mana, and after every kill, he'd get more and more HP. It's just impossible to deal with.
It's amazing at level 4. Level 4 would give you like 360 HP per kill.
Yep.
Seconds, and God, that math is a lot harder. 600 mana per kill when you have level 4.
I mean, you're pretty much regen if you get a kill. This is what happens.
Yeah.
Which is nice, because that means you can like, you get a kill, you can cast your mech if you're out of mana. He already has a decent mana pool as it is. He's got 700 mana right now. Call down will go, shackle shot will not latch, call down will hit, power shot will go, but there's the last, they're gonna bring up to the high ground. Can block out of that. It doesn't even matter. They missed it nonetheless. The ice shards will not block him completely, but here's the cast. The firefly will go with the extra because it's up. The snowball to the high ground. Shackle shot will not latch, and they actually bring him in with the snowball. Fun is going to try to TP out. Flame break, not there. Doesn't have it. Actually skilled up. Stunbeak getting his spirit siphoned, and now there's a buyback coming in. There's no call down, and SKP is going to run right in. He's looking for MSS. Can't find it. 6-2 the score. MSS might be in trouble. Power shot misses. There's the decay. Can they chase after him? Rocket Brush, but they're not enraged, and MSS has put himself in a corner. Now the snowball goes. Mineski fan is in trouble. Ice shards are not there. They need another hero mid. He will not die to the tower hits, and the decay will grab the kill for Jbay. I think if he just turned around and maybe had enough time to get off his ice shards, he might have gotten that kill.
He's on cooldown. He played that as well as he could. He dodged the power shot like twice there. He bought himself a lot of time and his team a lot of time, but his allies just couldn't back him up. So really nicely played by MSS there, but didn't quite keep.
I mean, that was a close. I mean, and Mason wasn't even in that fight, by the way. He was just bottom farming. And he has
probably
the
should have TP'd, yeah, honestly. He has a mango as well, so it's not like he's limited on mana. Like, he definitely could have killed at least the gyro. Unless he just bought the T or something. What probably would have happened is Ike's mic might have interrupted it with the vacuum, so he would have had to back off enough. He didn't have that opportunity.
I mean, regardless, they killed the gyro and he bought back, and the gyro got one kill out of it.
Yeah, but if you teleport in and you ulti and kill him with Reaper Scythe and he's dead for like 100 seconds at 11 minutes in, that would be insane.
And that's even more game losing at that point than just buying back. I feel you. Still, not that bad coming out for Shazam. They're looking to grab Mason here. Shackle Shot will most certainly last. He does have his mech. I don't know if they can bring him down in time. There's the mech. Pops up the Death Pulse, and look at the damage that Sunbeam and Jubei have taken. Back wall's gonna fly. It's actually doing a decent amount of damage. Look at that last one coming in. Mineski fan is dead yet again. Requiem, or rather this Reaper Scythe, is not there because he's dead now, but here comes Ritsu. Doesn't have the exorcism, and they're actually losing this fight. 2-2 Troid so far. They get the double kill on Bryce. He's actually salvaging this. SVG was not there. He's looking for Sunbeam. Not that that's going to do anything. The cast is not going to fly. The Observer Ward is up, and Sunbeam and the rest of the crew will actually back out of this. But Mischief get more out of this fight. They get 1,000 gold change. They get 1,300 experience, whereas there's only 400 gold going the way of Shazam.
Yeah, it was actually an MSS mistake. When he charged the snowball, he didn't bring Mason in. So they were just sitting there taking damage, and he ended up dying. So I think also Mason was a little too committed to going for the tombstone. He basically just sat there when he got initiated on and hit the tomb. And I think he should have walked back a little bit. Like, yeah, he got vacuumed and stuff, but he should have been a little bit more assuming that he could actually die despite how farmed he was.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, I mean, he's farmed with a mech, but he's not the tankiest hero. He's got less than 1,000 HP with the entrance put on, and he did die. I mean, he didn't even get a Reaper Scythe off. He got the Reaper Scythe off that on Mineski fan, like you talked about. He's dead forever, but that's not actually the case. There was no exorcism for Ritsu, and SVG was not in the fray. Ritsu is looking for a Yule. He's going to have it pretty soon. No Staff of Wizardry yet. And then, of course, the Sage's Mask is next after that. It gets an Arcane Room, which is pretty nice. MSS looking for more farm top. Look at his Arcane Boots, something else there. They probably could just go with Lasso now again. They could just find a fight. They have Exorcism. They could bring up the Reapers. They can bring up the Necro and just try to find somebody, but I'm not sure that's going to be what they do. Mason down bottom again. Looks like they know that he's there. They could have ganked him with IX Mike. They actually get it on Observer War 2, so there's no vision bottom, and Mason's going to have to hightail it out of there.
There's smoke on Batrider setting up for the push mid. That way, if somebody goes to deny, they can get the kill, and they're going to grab Bat.
Yeah, and his poor freaking Gyrocopter cannot find any room to work with. They even dropped the Death Ward just for, you know, safekeeping, just to make sure they actually get the kill.
That was a really cool gank there, that they comboed it with a push, so it looked like Death Prophet was just trying to snake a tower for free, and instead they actually had gank. Like, I really like that little gank. It was perfectly
And they get the tower on top of it too, which is pretty nice. Mech is done for the Darkseer. I mean, it's not really, usually you see Darkseer like, okay, he's gonna get a mech, it's gonna be pretty early. But you never have to deal with the mech on the other side. It's built at before 10 minutes. Still, though, he does get a pretty early time mech, and now that's going to mean that there's going to be one on either side. And I think he's pretty... He's level 9. You definitely need more levels in the Dark. You're level 2 ulti, obviously. He's got 2 points into Surge, 2 into Vacuum, so he actually does some decent damage. Just Darkseer can win them a couple of fights, and he pretty much won them that last fight, too.
Well, the creep wave's gonna be stopped at least. They won't be able to take a free tower, but they are moving a lot of heroes down.
Here's Sunbeam. He's got 2.4k gold, by the way. He's looking for somebody. MSS is already backed, and he actually just caught the creep wave. That's one of the most unfortunate timings I've seen.
They saw Witch Doctor TP top as well. They had a ward by the tier 1, so that means they're going to push for the tower for sure and force the fight if they can, because they know Witch Doctor can't be there. And they're also going to see Batrider. They know that this tower's free.
Yep, and it's already low in HP. Not only can they take this tower, they can even keep going for the 2-2 or rotate top. I doubt they'll all TP in top tier 1. They could. I think they have TPs enough to do it. That's not the right one. There we go. And they all have TPs, I believe, ready. Yeah, they do. If they wanted to defend this tier 1 tower top lane, they certainly could do it by just mass TP. But they're not. They're going to rotate mid.
It's a hard fight for them to win with Batrider and Reaper Scythe. Like, Batrider grabs any person. If he's a little bit low, they just lose the fight, pretty much.
The first one to TP in is going to die in that situation.
Unless they get a Grave off, but even still, it's going to be dangerous. And Point Booster is up on Mason now. He's going to Ags immediately afterwards. Just so that they can guarantee that they can't buy back if they do get kills, which Batrider will provide them.
Shadow dies, and keep going. No Ags first, which is not the worst thing. I mean, I'm glad he went for a damage item, but I didn't know it was going to be Shadow Blade. Roman, Blink Lasso, Mike's going to get caught. They pop the Exorcism as well. Mike is about to die. Can he get the mech off in time? He does. Silas comes through, and Bud cannot get that Grave, as you mentioned. Jube getting caught out as well. He's low. The Spirit Siphon keeps going. Exorcism goes. Just chase him down and run him into the ground. Sunbee in trouble. Ice Shards will connect on him. They don't have detection, though, and Sunbee will make it out alive. But still, Ritsu gets a triple kill. And he's going to look in, he's going to see, I want that rune, but he can't quite get it. But bottom lane, Mineski fan, you're not the fastest pusher.
Oh, Ritsu found him.
Uh-oh, Sunbee. Yeah, he actually juked him. But they're going to look for Mineski fan instead. There's no lasso. He does have Flamebreak, I believe. There's a TP.
He's just following him. He's not going to let him TP.
There's no way. Mineski fan said, for sure. He's going to buy a wand and then die. Or a racer, I guess. A Drum of Endurance, yeah.
I feel like Brex is just really outplaying everybody this game. He's playing very, very well.
Yeah, this game got so much harder just then. I mean, it was already pretty hard to begin with. Last was back up in 16. Everyone else is still bottom. They're smoked it behind Mike. They're, like, looking for this kill, and I like this bait, but there's already a lot of heroes here for Shazam. They're going to pop up the Yules onto Mike, and Jibe's going to pop that Flesh Golem, and here we go. Somebody's going to jump in, looking for a potential Shackle Shot, but get silenced up, and now Shazam are actually leaving. They're like, we don't have Exorcism. It's not time to fight right now. Force him back, and now Mason is going to be the lone one here in front. Echo shot, is it there? It will latch, and Mason might be in trouble here. He's got the Ags, or rather the mech, and he's gonna pop it off. The Death Ward comes through the back wall, but it's not enough damage. They're losing so many already. Mike's already dead. The Reaper's on his Sunbee, but Brick Rain from Fun. They get it off in time, but Sunbee should still go down. Gets the Shackle Shot off in the Ritsu. Ice Shards, double kill for MSS, and Mineski fan trying to go toe to toe with the Flak, and he cannot get it off and do enough damage. And they wipe Mischief off the face of the goddamn planet without Exorcism.
That's gold advantage in Necrofrost, man. Like, every 4 seconds or whatever, 5 seconds, you can heal your team for 130 apiece. That's like, if in 10 seconds, double mech, basically. Plus, you have the actual mech, so you triple mech. Or, well, sorry, double, two means one mech, therefore the second mech. Okay, but there's so much healing that you put out in AoE damage.
That's it, man.
That, I don't blame them, dude. They had to win that fight, and they got absolutely... The game ends now. Necrofrost is gonna get his Ags. He's gonna ulti whoever gets low. Like, they didn't even have single. They don't even have gank heroes. Like, how are they gonna get kills? That run went insane. Like, literally everything went right there for Shazam. And they had all the heroes to scale later. They, like, completely outdrafted Mischief, in my opinion.
There's no way they win that, I think. That's just,
I mean,
too tough.
They could if they were much better, but unfortunately, there's only so much you can do.
Yeah, no, I agree. Yeah. Either way, Shazam will take the victory, and they do it in a pretty quick fashion of 18 minutes and 15 seconds. Outstanding.